So we have a brand new MCU skin officially revealed for Hawkeye, as you can see in the background. The question is it a yay or is it a nay for you guys? Leave your constructive criticism in the comment section below, because if you don't do it, the entire internet will do it for you, because that's basically what has happened in like the last 2 hours. But I can tell you a legitimate fact, and that is that there are more people watching Marvel's Avengers content, like across the entire internet, whether it be articles, screenshots, news, videos, whatever it may be, then there are people loading up the game. Like, I am really standing by that, because I know it's a real thing, and I guess it just speaks so many, I guess, volumes, as they would say, right? Because if that doesn't speak a lot, then I don't really know what does, because at this moment in time, I could be completely wrong. Maybe there's like a million people playing on PlayStation 4 right now. I would never know, but I feel like it's almost a fact, because when we take a look at the interest in general, it's almost like a no-brainer, because there's still no content, there's still nothing that's really, I guess, gauging you into the game, and it feels like a never-ending promise that is kind of delivering, but kind of not delivering. But I can tell you who is delivering, and that is Instant Gaming, because they are today's sponsor of the video, and they do a bunch of brand new games for an unbeatable price. I always use them to get some PlayStation Network cards, and honestly, you'd be crazy not to use them. So go ahead and visit that link, which is in the description below. But look, let's get down to the basics with the MCU skin before anybody says, because I've already seen it on some comments, right? Just in general, on like Twitter, Reddit, etc., that, you know, the Avengers community really want MCU skins. Then they get it, and then they complain. Let's just slow this down, okay? So, I can tell you one thing, alright? If this is a skin that you need to pay 15 bucks for, like, come on. I guess you can kind of look, and it's like, why has there been so much effort in the skin itself, which is good and all, like, I'm not going to criticize that. But like, when it gets down to the basics, i.e. a head, some people would say, I don't really care about this. I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of torn in between that, because one thing we were told is like, hey, don't worry, it's MCU skins. Sure, it says inspired, but you know, don't really worry about that. That's what we were told. But the situation is, it's like, okay, you're right, it is the MCU skin. Like, it's the outfit, so technically you cannot argue that. But at the same time, it's not. And I mean, there was somebody on Twitter, I think it was, that actually done, I guess, a side-by-side comparison. Now, I want to give a shout out to somebody who goes by the name Haze Eternal, I believe is how you pronounce it. And to the left is what we have, the bald Hawkeye, right? That's who we've been stuck with for a while. And then on the right, you have essentially how this endgame could have potentially looked with a different hairstyle. Now look, I know it sounds crazy when people really come down to the basics and it's like, okay, everything else is okay, but it's like, oh, why doesn't my character have hair? Like, I completely get why people would also say, you know, well, that's a weird thing to kind of complain about, but then equally, I understand other people's perception of things, because it's like, okay, it's not technically a free suit, it's gonna be something you have to pay for, so like, why would you not almost want to take the money from me? Like, why would you not want to give me something that I really want, and something so small that then I no longer want to buy because you decided not to, in this case, adhere onto a character? I know you're gonna get people in the comments that go ahead and say, hey, you know, it's a lot harder than that, it's a lot more difficult, etc, etc. Well, let's also go down to the basics a little bit more on that, because I get that. Like, I've never ever developed a game, I probably never will, although I would like to, but I know it's not easy. One thing I do know, though, is that I guess we have like the bald Hawkeye for most outfits, but the point is, there is other Hawkeyes where there is a different facial appearance, whether it be the hair, the face in general, whatever it may be. So like, you kind of have to ask the question, is it legit like a licensing problem at this moment in time, hence the inspired word now actually playing into action, or is it not? Like, is it just something that is just, I guess, down to developers not really wanting to do? I don't know, I'm kind of torn in between that, but what I can tell you is that if they continue doing this, it's just not going to help them, because naturally, I mean, I've seen so many people leave comments on that screenshot saying if it had been the actual, like, endgame skin in general, like, it was the actual character and not the bald Hawkeye, like, I would have definitely gone ahead and purchased it for, like, $15 or whatever it's going to be. Like, there are people saying that this small factor basically just distinguishes, like, oh, I'm not going to go ahead and purchase this simply because of that. And now I kind of get it. Like, I actually understand these people that are, like, mega hardcore fans when it comes down to these skins as a whole. I understand why somebody would not want to buy it anymore. That's just my two cents on it. But what I do want to mention is the next thing, which I think is really, really cool. And it's kind of going off a little bit off topic, but somebody on Reddit, as you will see on screen, basically shared this screenshot. Now, it's another way to keep the player base active, just logging in the game all the time, and it's basically a login calendar. Now, we don't know who actually created this, so if somebody knows who made this, by all means, let me know in the comments so we can go ahead and give some credit for that, because it really, really is good. And, I mean, it's a good concept. Now, there are people saying that it's basically just a challenge card for logging in, but I guess that's the challenge, right? The challenge is right there. The challenge is logging into the game. So, like, I know how bad this sounds. I really understand how terrible it sounds, like, from, I guess, their marketing team in general and, like, trying to draw players in, but it's a small thing that would probably go a really, really long way. Like, you look at the overall idea and it's laughable, and then you think, well, actually, it kind of shows that people genuinely still care about the game, hence what I said at the start of this video. There are more people that care about the news for this game than there are that are people that log into the game. So this would kind of just, I guess, prove my point to some extent, right? That's how I feel about it. That's really my perspective on the whole situation. But leave your thoughts on that in the comment section below. Now, also, the other day we did get a look at the first, well, ever kind of like screenshot of post level 50 progression, which we know is going to be a thing, which is going to be fun. It gives you a reason to play again and further just make your characters a lot more powerful than they probably should be. So that's always a perk. You can't really complain on that. But like I said, when we come down to the basics, I don't know. I'm really torn in between. Like, people are saying, well, you know, for example, Rebel, you kind of like the game at some points and you don't like the game, etc. I guess the situation that I'm in is like, sure, I like the game. I think the game's fun. But how much can you play of the game also, right? And this is the mega key point here, that when it comes down to the skins, if it's like something you're really anticipating, and when it's like such a small thing in some sort of way, but that goes a long way, it kind of feels like, oh, is it almost like a cash grab for the skins and they're kind of like, I guess, just half doing it? Or is there a reason being of a licensing problem, hence the word inspired, and the word inspired basically being a big thing now that we should take into consideration? Now, if I was them, and this is me being brutally honest, what I would have done is had like a feature where you can just kind of swap heads on any outfit. That alone would solve a lot of problems. That's my theory. That's what I think would be really good, but I guess if you made it this far to the video, congratulations, because it means you also care as much as I do. But guys, that's going to wrap up this video here, so I'll see you in the next one. Till then, have yourselves a ridiculously amazing day, and until the next one, adios amigos.